Subs say yes way to a whole new way to Subway.
Braden Voigt last year in game number 6. This season, Morgan Riley game 3. Alex Kerfoot game 4. Who's going to be the hero tonight? And Sheldon Keefe liked the way his team attacked overtime in game number 4. It looks like they're ready to go to the attack with Matthews, Marner, and Nylander to start up against Stamkos, Cirelli, and Killorn. And up off Matthews and down into the Lightning zone. Darren Radish back to get it. He's out along with Sergachev. Kept in at the line by Shin. And now played into the Leafs zone. Riley gets back there and Shin will flip it back out. Is that going to be enough for icing on the fresh ice? It is. Icing against Toronto.
What's always interesting in these moments is which team can keep that aggressive play. Both these sides like to pinch their D down and stay aggressive and try to get in on the forecheck hard, and sometimes that'll open you up to an odd man rush the other way. See if they play cautious or if they go right after it.
Shin shoulders Stamkos off the puck, but Killorn gets back on it. Back to the line, Radish has 4 shots in the game. Shin in behind the net for the Leafs. Up ahead, Nylander, and he'll scoop it out and hit somebody at the benches and play call.
Well, that's a better outcome for Nylander there than having an icing. So it gets a little bit of a break and don't have to worry about maybe a bit of a tired group. You saw that lineup. I don't mind that from Sheldon Keefe at all. The guys were talking about Marner and Matthews going together, put him with Nylander. The question, as the rotations continue on, you get not many whistles. What different combinations will you use with just the 11 forwards?
And 5 of those forwards without a shot on goal in the game. None from O'Reilly, Tavares, Achari, Knies, or Yarncroak. Red line and in for Nick Pervix in his first Stanley Cup playoff series. Battle along the boards. TJ Brody trying to work it loose. And now it's Braden Voigt up high. Here comes a shot. That blocked by McCabe, whipped through the goal mouth. And back it comes to Hedman. Looked across and finds Kucherov. Shooting. Blocked by McCabe, who leads all skaters in ice time here in game number 6. Now O'Reilly comes up with a puck outside the line. Lost possession, back in, Hagel and Kucherov. Pass on the left flank, too far for Kucherov. And Brody able to fight off the back check of Kucherov to work it free. And here's Lilligren. Again, a birthday tomorrow, looking for a press up to deep. Fired that high. Ricochets back the other way. Colton's got Asimov loose. Mikey Asimov, and he's stopped by Samsonov. There's the first good chance, and maybe another coming. And that shot blocked in front. Leafs have been good at blocking the shooting lanes tonight. Now Marner ahead. Here is Giordano scooping it down into the Lightning zone. Marner nearly picked the pocket of Cole, but it's out at center where Shen buries his man, and the fans react. Asimov taken down. Now Tavares out at center, comes up with a loose puck, and here we go with Kerfoot trying to wheel in. Knocked off his stick by Cole, who rides him into the boards. Up to the speedy Asimov again. Pass ahead for Maroon, and that'll bounce right to Samsonov, who gets the stick up on Big Pat Maroon, one of only 2 Lightning players along with Corey Perry without a shot tonight.
You know, there's a few givens as a player when you come in on the one side. Watch all the room here for Lilgren. What you can't do is miss the net. I mean, it goes right up the glass. It gives a breakout for the opponents, and all of a sudden Tampa's in on a 2-on-1. Asimov with the quick shot, and look at the difference this time around. Remember the goal he scored in game 5 in tight and deep in his net with Samsonov. Great positioning there. Asimov just watched that one on the big screen. Samsonov came out and gave him nothing.
31 stops for Samsonov. 36 in game 3 is his series high. Faceoff won by Belmar. Here's Cole ripping it wide. And Cole, one shot on goal of the series, and he scored on it. A look there, but he missed the target. Then away goes Yarncroak along with Achari. Scoops it down, and Achari on the hunt against Bogosian. Played around the boards, and TJ Brody steps up, centers it, and Aaron Cook unable to redirect that toward the net. Getting back defensively, and here's McCabe in his own zone. Corey Perry trying to pick his pocket. Comes back to Belmar. Corey Perry with five career Stanley Cup overtime goals. Maroon. Now it's Radish. Back in the corner, Maroon. In front, Cirelli! And that went up Brody wide. Another close call. Pat Maroon up high. Steered to Sergachev. That blocked by McCabe. Bounces to the side of the net. McCabe there to take over. Sidesteps Cirelli and works it out to center ice.
This pair working on a minute, almost a minute 20 now for McCabe and Brody.
And stolen there by Stamkos. Matthews there to help out. Kept in at the line. Bouncing puck for Cirelli. He'll get it to Alex Killorn. Now Killorn up high. Hands it off Sergachev. Tried to center that, hit a skate. And the Leafs will get it out. Maybe a break here for Nylander. Trying to cut in against Sergachev. Nylander in behind the net. Follows up. Gets that pass to Riley, who steered it wide. Shin from distance. Ricochets to Riley. Matthew Nyes goes after the puck behind the net. The rookie comes up with it. Trapped there by Cirelli. Now it's Tavares in the far corner. Riley still up there. And it's played for Shin, who missed his pass, but Tavares keeps it going, and it's John Tavares behind the net. Coming out in front, John scores! John Tavares! They finally caught lightning in a bottle! And the Maple Leafs have broken the 19-year curse!
Of piles of celebration, one for the goal scorer. How about the goaltender, though? Samsonov again, a great story. Here's the quick little turnaround off the skate of Radish in front. Vasilevsky never even saw it. But how about Morgan Riley? He said, can the D be aggressive, continue to go to the areas where it's going to make a difference? And years of frustration, all kinds of different moves and plans. How about the trade deadline, the new additions? But John Tavares, the captain, keeps that play alive. After the captain, Steven Stamkos, had tied it in the third, the Leafs move on with the overtime win.
John Tavares ended a playoff drought of 23 years for the Islanders back in 2016, and he ends an excruciating 19-year playoff drought for the Maple Leafs, and he'll go into the books with Gary Falk, Nikolai Borshevsky, Lanny McDonald, and the legendary Bill Parilko with series-winning overtime goals.
The playoffs are all about those kind of special moments, aren't they? And, you know, they hung in there, gave up the lead, and got this game to overtime, and it didn't take long. How about Tampa Bay? They're now 1-10 in their last Stanley Cup playoff overtime.
And lose their last four consecutive home games over 2 years in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Excuse me, five now. Leafs winning here three times, and who had that?
Great respect there, a point in Morgan Riley. What a series for Morgan Riley after a frustrating offensive year, an injury that kept him out, and you know, all kinds of questions of where's his offense gone. He was a force all playoff series long, and he was right there on the doorstep in front of Vasilevsky, causing problems as that shot went in off the skate of Radish.
31 stops for Samsonov, Cirelli, and Matthews, who have dueled throughout this series, exchanging words. And the Leafs beat a great team, a team that has won two cups, won the Eastern Conference three consecutive years, and now with Game 7 tomorrow, Boston, Florida.
There's the talk from warm-up. They had their moments there, but you could see the respect, the friendship, and you go through those experiences, that's exactly the kind of reaction you're going to get.
Leafs don't have to win this handshake line.
No, not at all, and there's an awful lot of respect both ways. Auston Matthews, you think of the pressure, okay, you don't get a 60-goal year, you get a fifth 40, but four games in a row, he's put the puck in the back of the net. That's what you need from your top guys. And I credit the fact that the Leafs had a lot of their top guys playing big minutes in that 11-7 setup. And in the end, that had a big impact on this game and in this series.
John Cooper has coached Mitch Marner at the World Championships. And he talked about how much firepower, how much talent was on this team. And now probably a message that for Austin Matthews that you're just part of the way through the journey now.
Hey, you never like losing. But with John Cooper, is what he's gone through in the last three consecutive Stanley Cup finals, he knows what it means to Sheldon Keefe to get finally that win in the books and move along.
Let's hit down to ice level. Here's Kyle.
All right, alongside Austin Matthews, you are through to the second round of the playoffs for the first time. Just tell me what you're thinking.
I mean, it's a great feeling. Obviously, this is step one of three, so. Obviously, it's a bit of a monkey off our back, and you know, we still got plenty of work to do, but this one obviously feels really great.
You seem to just have a flatline focus all series long. How would you describe your level of determination to ensure a different outcome this time around?
Yeah, I mean, it's you get thrown so much in these series, and you know, there's so many ups and downs, and it's just a roller coaster. So just trying to stay even keeled and just enjoy the moment, stay present, and I'm just so proud of every guy in this locker room just battling our way. And like I said, I mean, this is a small step into where we're trying to go, but obviously this is a big one for us.
Right, and now that you're over it, what do you believe this team is capable of going forward?
Well, I don't think I need to tell you that. I mean, obviously we have the belief in our room, but we're still a long way from where we want to go. So just got to stay in the moment here, get ready for this next round.
Awesome, congrats.
Thank you.
Chris.
All right, the official on the goal, Tavares with his third of the series. How about Matthew Nyes on for all three overtime goals in this series? Gets an assist along with Morgan Riley, who was as good as anybody in this first round.
And there's just the mindset of not being afraid to attack in playoff time. Nyes, who made the mistake on the tying goal, makes amends, keeps the puck alive down low. Tavares with the quick stop back. It's not a risky play. It's getting the puck to the net off the skate of Radish. But Morgan Riley on the doorstep, as he's done all series long, gets in there offensively. He makes an impact, and the release at the other end. Samsonov with maybe his best game of this series as well, under the gun, and he stepped up big to preserve the win.
Three overtime victories for the Leafs and three wins here at Amalie, and the reactions, and we can only imagine what the celebrations are looking like in Toronto and across Leaf Nation.
There's that victory leap. Sheldon Keefe, you don't think there's been some pent-up energy watching from the press box. One of the most difficult things to do. And as Austin Matthews said, it's just the first step. But man, have they grown in that coming up the step.
After 11 straight losses in elimination games, the Leafs get it done, and the celebration on in Toronto. Let's head back there and hear from them.